Hi, I'm Steve Dwyer, founder of Edify Hub. For the last few weeks, we've been talking about how to protect yourself on your iPhone or Android on the internet using accountability software accountable to you. Today, I want to walk through how to set up your account to send reports to your accountability partners. So before we look at how to set it up, what I'd like to do is take a look at what does one of those reports look like. So I'm going to give you an example of a report of my activity. It came out just this morning. It's about the activity from yesterday. So let's take a look. What we see here first is it's an accountability report. We have my name. This is the name that I assigned to my account when I signed up with Accountable to You. This is going to be the same for every device that you have. It will have this name that identifies you. The next thing that we see is the computer name. Every time we walked through installing the software, it asked us for a device name. This is the name here. This is how you can tell which computer visited which websites or had what activity. So if you have multiple devices, if everybody in your family has their own smartphone or their own laptop or computer, you can give a name to each device that lets you know which accountability report refers to which device. So that's what comes up next. But here's the interesting part down here. This is the activity that occurred during that time frame. So we see here are all the entries for all the different apps and how many different things happened during the time of the report. Down here we see where it will highlight the questionable activity. Now the value here is that I don't necessarily have to open up every one of those links to see, all right, well, what was their activity in the Finder? What was their activity in Skype? What was their activity in Chrome? What was their activity in Firefox or whatever browser? We can just look for the questionable activity if we just want to get a quick idea of what's happening, whether we need to drill in and look deeper. So we just look for the questionable activity first, then we can look at the details. We can actually click on any of these links and see in quite a bit of detail everything that happened over that time period. You see here we have three full pages of activity that occurred just during the time that I was using it in the evening. You can get all the detail. Every entry has a rating, and here's the legend up here. The green dots, it's not questionable. There's no question about what was happening. And then it has some rating where it just analyzes and says it's somewhat questionable, it's questionable, or highly questionable. I found some words in here that make me really think that this really needs to be looked into. The full report shows everything. If there were questionable activity, you would see that up here at the top in its own separate section. Here's the questionable activity. And that is the detail for this one app. Close that and come back and look at that. So that was the report that your accountability partners get. So now that we know what it looks like, well, let's figure out how to set it up so that we can send that to somebody. So what we want to do is go to the Accountable to You website and sign in. You can get there by going to edifyhub.com/accountable. If you don't have an account and you haven't looked through the previous videos to see how to set things up, you can go to edifyhub.com/accountable. That will take you straight to the Accountable to You sign-up page and login page. It's the same place. If you don't have an account, just hit the sign-up button. And when you do, I've received a promo code from Accountable to You. If you put in edifyhub, all one word, lowercase, as the promo code, they will extend your free trial from 10 days to a full 30 days. You get your first 30 days free when you use my promo code EDIFYHUB when you sign up for Accountable to You. If you already have an account, go ahead and put your sign in using your account name and password right here. And we're going to use the fictitious couple that we signed up with on the previous video. His name is Sam Evening, and we'll sign in for him. So now that we're signed in, we come back to the Member Center. We've seen this before when we installed the software. Now that we have different devices set up, We can go to the partners section. Now here are all of the device names that we set up for Sam. Sam's Android, Sam's iPad, Sam's iPhone. And then we can go and add or view partners. So let's go and add some partners to Sam's Android. There are two different ways that a partner can be alerted. We'll see here at the top, we can alert by email address. So I can put in Sam's wife, Janet. Put in her email address. Then I have a choice to make. How frequently do I want to send a report? This is a really good conversation to have with your accountability partner before you set them up. How often do you want to report? I can send you a report every day, and every morning you'll get an email that says this is my activity from the previous day. You can also say I'm going to send one every week, and then every Saturday morning, Eastern Standard Time, it will send a report of the previous week's activity. Another possibility, if you're going to have an accountability partner that is an accountability partner for many people and they have a lot of activity, they might want to get just the alerts and not have every day or every week, but only get a report when there's questionable activity. If you choose the alerts only option, which is the third one here, if you choose alerts only, what happens every hour, accountable to you looks back to see what activity happened, and if there was anything that was not somewhat questionable, but questionable or highly questionable, it will send an email at that time without waiting for the next daily or weekly report, and it will send an activity of that information. In this case, most of mine are set up to be daily, so we'll leave this as daily. When I hit save, here is that email address. And it's going to be sent daily. You can choose to remove the partner. If you remove the partner, they will get an email saying that you have taken them off. So you can't use the removal to get around being accountable. Let's take a look and see what email they get. When you choose somebody to be an accountability partner, here's the email that they're going to get. It says, in this case, it's Steve Dwyer has selected you to be this member's accountability partner. You'll be receiving an accountability report daily. And it gives them a link right there where they can go and check on the activity at any time. So they don't have to wait for a report. If you want to set up somebody where you have a meeting with them once every week or every 2 weeks, as long as they keep a copy of this email, then when you go to meet with your accountability partner, they can pull up the same email from the beginning, click that link, and instantly get access to all of your activity for checking up on accountability. So now let's go back and look at some of the other ways that we can set up accountability. So we can set it up by email. We talked about daily, weekly, and hourly options. In addition to email, you can set up a SMS text message alert. Now, when something becomes highly questionable, not just the somewhat or questionable, but when it crosses that threshold and becomes highly questionable, accountable to you can throw out an SMS, a text message, to an accountability partner, and your accountability partner can check into it and decide that they just might need to intervene immediately. Let's not wait for that hourly report to come out, or that hourly alert email. Let's not wait for the daily or the weekly, or for our bi-weekly meeting to look and see. If you've got something highly questionable, you can set it up to request accountable to you to send them a text message. So if we look here, you can choose any of a number of different countries. Most of us that I know are going to be in the United States, so it's fairly simple. We just choose United States, put in the area code and local phone number. Sam is in Fiji. So Sam needs to send his to a Fiji account. That's country code 679. Now, Accountable to You has a lot of options here, but they don't have Fiji. So what's Sam going to do if he wants his accountability, highly questionable alerts to go directly to his wife? Don't pass go. Don't collect $200. He can't set up yet. He can't set up a SMS text alert to go directly to a Fiji phone number. But he's not out of luck. Here's a bonus tip. If you want to get SMS text messages from the U.S. and you're not in the U.S., try setting up a Google Voice number. Now, your Google Voice can forward the texts to another phone number, but only if it's a U.S. phone number. What you can do is to install the Google Voice app on your phone, on your smartphone, Android or iPhone, and then when you get an SMS text message to your U.S.-based Google Voice number, it will use the internet, not the mobile cellular network. It will send an alert over the internet to your phone, to that Google Voice app, and it'll do a push notification and will still alert you. So it uses a different technology, a different network, but the outcome is the same. If you set up a Google Voice number with the smartphone app, then put your United States as the country code, put your phone number in there of your Google Voice phone number, or of the Google Voice phone number of your accountability partner who lives outside the United States. And then when there is a highly questionable activity on your device, then it can send an alert using the internet to the Google Voice number, and they'll still be able to reach it even though they're in Fiji. So this is the second of the ways that we can reach out to an accountability partner. And that gives a lot of flexibility to how to keep yourself accountable with your partners. Now you'll notice the third section here, it's not about setting up partners, but it's a question of how strict or how paranoid do you want accountability to you to be when it looks at what you're doing. I've left mine on normal. Every once in a while I do get some of my activity gets flagged as highly questionable, especially when I'm doing research for preparing for articles on pornography. Even those from a Christian perspective talking about pornography will have keywords that show up that get flagged as a little bit sensitive, and they cross the threshold of being highly questionable. Now, my accountability partners know that when they get those alerts, they read them. And they can tell whether it's just the software being overly cautious or whether there's a problem. And I have one accountability partner who will actually email me when he receives those and says, "Brother, I know this one isn't a problem. I just want to let you know I'm paying attention." And that's a real encouragement to me, to let me know that he cares enough to encourage my Christian growth, that he'll read every alert, and he will reach out to me just to let me know that he's watching. So we've seen how we set up accountability partners with Accountable to You. We've seen an example of the report. So let me challenge you. Get an account set up with Accountable to You. Use the Edify Hub, one word. Use that promo code. Get yourself an extra time on your free trial. And set up a few of your devices, or set up all of your devices. I'd advise you to set your own email up account first. So then you will start getting those accountability reports. Then, challenge you, please reach out to some accountability partners. Encourage and enlist some other godly men who will come alongside you and help you to stay pure with your activity on the internet. Thanks for watching the video. Hope this has been an encouragement to you.